Hey everybody, Shoebox Legends here. Thanks for joining me for another episode. And today we are going to spend a few minutes talking about relic cards. Of course, you know, game used jersey or bat piece or patch cards. Something you probably haven't seen much of here on the channel in the relatively brief time that I've been on YouTube. And I guess the reason for that is these have sort of fallen out of favor with me over the years, and I thought they were pretty neat when I first got back into collecting as an adult and didn't really know any better, and the situation was a little different back then. And as the years have gone by here, I've just gotten, I guess, less and less attracted to these, and nowadays I rarely, if ever, would seek out a relic card for my collection. But I do have a bunch from back when I was in that phase that I've held on to, pulled a small stack of them here and thought I would just show some of these off, because I know it is something that other folks do enjoy, and I don't mean to disparage anyone's collecting habits or talk negatively about cards. It's just, you know, we all have things we are a little more interested in and a little less interested in, and for me, the relic card has gone from being the former to now the latter. So here's an example of why. So I don't remember where I got this card. This is a Pedroia relic out of 2015 Allen and Ginter. It's got a little jersey swatch here, navy blue, that looks nice and everything. Beautiful card. But what bothers me about this is that it's just sort of misleading. And I don't really trust that this jersey swatch was really a part of a Major League Baseball game at any point in time. And, you know, although the front says game used memorabilia clearly below the swatch and above the nameplate, when you turn the card over and read the back, it clearly says, "The memorabilia contained in this card is not from any specific game, event, or season." So that, to me, sort of devalues this a little bit, or just, you know, I guess I'm just not as excited about it as I would be if I knew that this actually came from a jersey that Pedroia wore in a major league game at some point during his career. And that's really the primary reason that these don't do a lot for me. I still have some, though. Like, here's one from my early days of returning to collecting. And maybe this is just me or kind of grumpy old man syndrome, but I feel like back then in like the mid to late 2000s, the relic cards were still a somewhat new novelty. And in most cases, they actually were, or at least purported to be, actual game used jerseys and bat pieces, which to me makes all the difference in the world. So here's a duel from 2005 Artifacts featuring Big Poppy and Pudge. Numbered out of 99, you got a nice red swatch for Poppy, and maybe some pants, you know, Pudge pants, I'm not sure. But if you flip this over, you know, the language makes all the difference here to me. Again, you know, I absolutely understand that you can question whether Upper Deck has enough credibility to be believed here. But at the very least, at least the back of the card states that these are authentic pieces of jersey worn by Ortiz and Fisk in official Red Sox MLB games. So even though I don't seek these out, this is a much cooler relic card to me for that reason alone. Aside from the fact that it features one current Hall of Famer and another guy who I'm convinced will get in at some point down the line. So that's kind of a neat one. Similarly, here's one from a set right around that same time, late 2000s. I don't think this release lived very long the Upper Deck canon, but this is the Ballpark Collection set. Nice dual relic here with Papelbon, who was a dominant closer there for a while, and of team captain Jason Veritek. And again, the language here indicates that this was used in an official MLB game for the Boston Red Sox. So kind of a neat one there for the same reason. But again, this is not a card that I consider prized among my collection, or that I wouldn't trade away, you know, in a trade with somebody if it made sense to do so. I just don't value these as much as I do other cards in my collection. Here's a Manny. This is a die cut relic. So this is kind of neat. And it's got some foil going on along the bottom where it says "We're number one" there. Pretty cool. Think I got this one in a trade as well. Don't remember buying this on my own. But a pretty neat one out of 2002 Fleer. And again, claims to actually be a game worn jersey. So a lot more respect for those. Later on, you know, not so much the case. So this one doesn't really say either way. Out of 2010 Gypsy Queen. Just sort of says it's a certified relic card. Alrighty. Says game used memorabilia above the red, but we saw what that means on the first card that we looked at Pedroia. This one's kind of neat. So The set that first got me back into collecting in 2007 was this Gaudi set, which were mini-sized cards reminiscent of like the 1930s Gaudi cards. I loved the artwork, and I stumbled upon a blaster of these in Target when I was doing some household shopping. I hadn't thought about or touched a baseball card in probably 10 years, and for whatever reason, I just stumbled across a blaster. It looked like some fun. I thought I would give it a try, and next thing you know, I was off and running, collecting again. I've since completed this entire set, including all of the high number short prints, which was pretty brutal. And back in the day, I had nearly the entire set of these relics as well, these Gaudi mini relics. But a while back, I sold or gave away or traded a lot of those to team collectors and player collectors and just kind of broke that up. It really wasn't for me to complete a relic set, for all the reasons I'm stating in this video, that it's just not my favorite pursuit in the hobby. But I did hang on to these two Red Sox cards just because they remind me of those early days of returning to the hobby and ripping open 2007 Gaudi blasters that I could actually find at Target for $19.99 anytime I wanted. Those were good days. Here's another one that came in a trade, Field of Game, Matt Clement out of Fleer Ultra. Nice design here. I like the matching red, but again, I sort of just view this as like an insert card in my collection, not really that special to me. Here's a classic materials, Fred Lynn. Kind of neat just to get a player who was around that long ago. It's sort of like an off-white swatch here. And looking at the back of this one, this does claim that it was a Red Sox Major League Baseball game that this material was used in. So again, you know, Upper Deck did a pretty good job with those, it seems like, back when they had their license, with the caveat that you actually have to believe them again. Here's a Bowman Sterling. Love the shine on this Curt Schilling. I think I picked this out myself out of like a dollar box back in the day. The lighting in here is not doing this justice, but it's a really nice foily type card, and it is numbered out at 25, as you can see on the upper right there in the back. So pretty cool. It does claim to be game-worn jersey on the front here. I won't repeat myself there. Here's a Heritage Clubhouse Collection bat, in this case, from Victor Martinez. I love this one because it does have a cartoon on the back. And Topps, again, is very upfront about saying that this is not from any specific game, event, or season. So, you know, there it is. There's a sweet swatch memorabilia, Josh Beckett with a red swatch. This one I've already checked in the past, I know, is game-worn Red Sox game, so props again there to Upper Deck. And I guess that's not surprising. Sweet Spot was sort of a mid to high tier product, so you would expect that. Same with this, which is out of Upper Deck Ultimate. It's Josh Beckett, Ultimate Star Materials. I got this one in a group break, which I haven't done one of those in probably 12 years, but got into a couple group breaks as the Red Sox when I first got back into the hobby and did pretty well pulling this Beckett. Here's a Manny out of Bowman Heritage. Kept this one just because I like that it spells out his full name, including middle name. I like the horizontal shot there. And I like the baseball player at bat cutout of the bat that is used for the relic portion of the card. So kind of a neat one that I think I paid a couple bucks for back in the day. Here's another one from my ultimate team break as the Red Sox got this Eucalyptus base numbered out of 75. And then I've been picking up on ComC. This is one of the few relics that I have picked a few up of in recent years, just because they're dirt cheap. And I do like these mini framed relics out of A&G. So I've made an effort to get somewhat of a Red Sox team run of these from over the years. I don't honestly recall where I stand with it. Probably still missing a handful, but I've got a Gonzalez used bat, Jed Lowry jersey, Jared Saltalamacchia, longest name in baseball, at least for a little while, probably still jersey, and Kevin Youkilis bat. And these four here are all from the 2011 Allen and Ginter release. I don't think I paid more than a dollar or two for any of those four, and I just thought they were kind of neat additions to my Red Sox collection. And then a couple more on that front here. Got a Veritek, oh, I'm sorry, an Adrian Gonzalez with a nice bright red swatch. This is the 2012 iteration with a very nice black ornate frame that they used that year. Again, this is like $2. Clay Buchholz was like $1.50. Manny Ramirez, this is an early one. You can tell by the border, the lighter border. Pretty cool card there. I like Manny, even though I understand his reputation's a little bit tarnished, but he was a fun guy. And then here's a similar one. This is out of Gypsy Queen, though. And this is John Lester. Just a white swatch there. And then we'll finish it off here. We're past the 10-minute mark with one other one that was in the stack. And this is one that I actually do enjoy, even to this day. Pretty cool here. First of all, Pedro is maybe the most dominating pitcher I've ever seen pitch with my own two eyes. Secondly, I love that this one is die cut in the shape of a baseball, designed as a baseball, and has the swatch right there on it. It does say right on the front that it's a game-worn jersey. And since this is Fleer, this expressly warrants the authenticity of this, and it does claim on the back to be a game-worn jersey worn by Pedro with the Boston Red Sox. So pretty neat. I got this one in trade years back, and it's always been one of my favorite kind of cheaper, obscure Red Sox relics. So thought after all that sort of negativity, which I hope it wasn't perceived as negativity, they're just something that doesn't do too much for me in the hobby, but to each his own. And to those of you that do collect and enjoy relic cards, I certainly mean no disrespect, and you can see that I have accumulated my fair share of them as well. But after all of that, you know, negativity, it's nice to end on one that I actually love quite a bit, and I'm very glad to have in my collection. So there you go, a little bit of rambling on relics. Thank you for sticking with me, and I'll certainly be back in the near future with some more sports card content. Until then, take care.